Welcome to the Magnolia Minute. I'm Corey Poole, and today I have with me Harriet Palmer, Associate Director for the Advanced Program for Young Scholars. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. How are you this morning?
Doing good.
Good.
So what can you tell us about the program?
Well, Advance has been at Northwestern State University for 31 years now.
Wow.
So our 31st session will take place July 7th to 27th. Our contact information is on that board. Write it down. Give us a call. It's for kids ages 12 to 17. Typically, they're currently in 7th grade through 11th grade. They're inquisitive, bright. They love to learn, and we love to challenge them. A lot of them go to really good schools, but they sit in class, they don't take notes, they don't have to read anything, they make an A, and they're just not challenged.
Mm-hmm.
So with our program, they'll take one course and they'll complete that course in 3 weeks.
Wow.
So they have to study. They find themselves saying, oh, I hope I do well on that test. And that's not common for a lot of them at home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What are some of the courses?
This summer we're offering, the maths are Algebra 1, Geometry, and Algebra 2. Our sciences are Biology, Chemistry, Physics, and Psychology. We have one programming course, and this summer it's going to be Java-based.
Hmm.
Our humanities, to me, they're just so fun because they're not typically offered in any regular high school.
Oh, yeah.
American West, all about the West, the Bronte Sisters. Creative writing. We're offering criminalistics for the first time in several years.
That's awesome.
I know, right? environmental literature, film studies, Shakespeare in performance, and women in ancient Greece and Rome.
Wow.
So you just don't find those elsewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And it really, these kids just lighten up, you know, when they say, wow, I really like this, and I wouldn't get to take it until I go to college. So we really encourage them to look at those, even if it's not something they absolutely love, they're going to end up loving it.
Mm-hmm. And so talk about getting a little taste of college. It's also a residential life
it
scenario.
It is. We get to use University Place 2, which is a nicer, newer dorm in mm-hmm. NSU. But our kids are really well supervised, and I like to stress that, especially to parents, if they're considering sending a 12-year-old. Our students don't walk around campus alone at all. They're always in groups of a minimum of 12 students and one staff member. Oftentimes, the group may have 30 kids and 3 staff members. So they're walking everywhere, even from the dorm to the cafeteria, cafeteria to the classroom. But they don't really mind it because it's not me supervising them. It's these really cool college students that we have hired to be our residential assistants and teaching assistants.
I gotcha. And a lot of the staff members that are teaching are NSU professors.
The instructors, yes.
Yes.
Many of the instructors are, but now our staff, they can go to college anywhere in the U.S.
Mm-hmm.
And apply to work this summer.
That's pretty
neat. Yeah, it is.
And a great opportunity for some of them,
It is. But they do have to qualify.
Mm-hmm.
So most of them have sat for an ACT or an ACT through Duke University's Talent Identification Program, and we use those scores to see if they're eligible for Advance. However, if you have not taken an ACT or an SAT, go online, and in our menu box, I want you to click on Eligibility, and you're going to see Alternate Admissions. So there's certainly a way for you to consider applying, and you can call me for more information about that or anything else regarding the program.
Sounds great.
All right. Yeah.
Well, if you're interested in the Advance program and you like some of the courses that they offer, reach out, see if you're eligible, and as always, thanks for watching.